The anime begins with this dude arriving at the university. He's extremely happy to have a girlfriend. It's basically what keeps him alive. After she breaks up with him, Kazuya cries like a good millennial. Another anime about college students this season. The anime audience is starting to age, so he remembers a lot of shameful things he did before bed. You know, like everyone else. You can give me a black eye, but nothing hurts more than the Pion Pion 210 tweets. He imagines his ex-girlfriend having with another guy. What kind of masochist is that kind of madness? He even has a boner thinking about it. Did you used to work in Darling in the Franxx before Rent a Girlfriend? Kazuya downloads an app to rent a girlfriend for a few hours, and you thought watching anime is for losers. The other day he is in front of the subway waiting for the girl. Here she is, and obviously she's hella cute. They had a stop at a cafe before they started, and what he thought about her was basically, "That's the most cringe thing I've ever seen in an anime, and I've watched Wada Mode." Their second stop is at the aquarium. This is the Glowlight Tetra. Who the fuck knows a fish name like that? In my opinion, these animals that live in the water should all be called just fish to not complicate. Fish. Big fish. Perverted fish. Ugly fish. Other ugly fish. Florida fish. Your mom. She says some shit in a slightly different way, so his wanker heart already has an erection. At the end of the date, she takes the initiative to hold his hand because this fucking beta doesn't have the balls too. When she crosses their fingers, he even comes in his underwear. She leaves by the subway. My god, Kazuya. She just left and you're already looking at your hand like that. At home, he realizes that she crosses her fingers with all the customers. How dreadful. As a mature millennial, he curses her a lot on Twitter. Half a minute later, he plans to spend all his savings buying her foot pack. Another date. This time he intends to take revenge on her. He attacks her without looking her in the eye, as if he doesn't care about it. What a pussy. Then they have problems with how many bags they should take. Dude, you know you became an adult when you go out to buy ties. Again, they go to the aquarium. These fish are neon tetras. The first time I saw this episode, one thought it was the same fish as before. He gets mad at her because who the hell studied fish names? Fucking fish names. People start watching their discussion. It doesn't matter if you're in Japan, the USA, or Antarctica, everyone stops their lives to watch a couple argue. She drags him to a separate place. Ichinose yells at him, she's totally furious, and yet he can only pay attention to her body. His cell phone rings, his grandmother was hospitalized. It seems like an easy excuse, but it's true. Getting there, his grandma's angry. The doctor said she should no longer eat lasagna sandwich with barbecue sauce for breakfast. They can't figure out who that girl is, since it is easier the math entirely changes than Kazuya to find a girlfriend. Well, she's being paid. Grandma asks that question that old and sexually frustrated people usually ask. God, this girl will end up going to Hollywood. And as an old person with a lot of free time, she loves to gossip with her friends. They run away because Ichinose doesn't want anyone to see her with Kazuya. And now it's time for the brilliant ideas that people only have in anime. Original idea by Amagami. Grandma finds them, but luckily she has serious hearing problems. I said luckily, but it's not grandma's luck. Kazuya is still under the bedsheet with Ichinose. This situation really turns him on, but only him. At the end of the day, Kazuya tells his family's story to Ichinose. Who the fuck cares? Absolutely I don't. Kazuya decides to let bygones be bygones and never rent a girlfriend again. I think that not renting a girlfriend should be a basic requirement of human decency. Oh my god, I really didn't expect it when they said they were both in their first year of university. Ichinose leaves, and Kazuya's friends ask him what's in between them both. But soon they realize we're talking about Kazuya and lose all hope. Kazuya is walking peacefully in the hall, then he's kidnapped inside the university. In fact, it was just a pretty girl dragging him to a room where they can be alone. I almost think something is gonna happen, but once again, it's Kazuya. She's still pretty in that outfit though. Well, if it's not another usual coincidence in anime that I just wasn't waiting for. She runs away into her apartment afraid of Kazuya. Maybe you think she's overreacting, but right now he's trying to watch her through the mail gap. Later, his grandma calls him by video call. You must be thinking it's very modern for an elderly woman, but does anyone under 25 make a video call by their will? She's playing one of those mobile games that make you bankrupt in 32 hours. She also tells you that she's gonna visit him, whether he wants to or not. His room is as messy as a whorehouse arranged by a blind dog. The main difference is that in one of these environments there's intercourse. Speak of the devil, he asks for help to Ichinose once again. She arrives at the place and asks where Ichinose is. She seems to have more interest in Ichinose than Kazuya himself. He tries to beg for help again, and I'm sure this is a jailable offense. They're quite noisy, but as I said, they're lucky his grandma is almost deaf. After that mess, he spends time with grandma. Only them three, Kazuya, his grandma, and the uncomfortable silence. She talks about how Kazuya has always been a loser. Ichinose listens to everything, she's so sneaky. Out of pity, she decides to help him at the last moment. Grandma has dehydration for crying too much, now she needs to be hospitalized again. The next day, he bumps into Mami-chan. He's still a fucking simp. She's Mami-chan, his ex-girlfriend aka Pion Pion 210. She gives his book back and goes away. In this few seconds he came twice. His friends show up and say she must have slept with another guy already. With such nice friends who need enemies. He still says that there's no chance for Mami to go out with such a loser again. By the way, Mami still cares, and she's kinda a psychopath. What's not a problem for the anime community, since she's a cute girl. Later, they visit grandma. She was about to jump off. Thanks, nurse. On the way back, they obviously meet people from uni. Here is still their neighborhood. His friends assume she's part of some religious sect, but they don't think she's a rental girlfriend. Because this is too sad even for Kazuya. Jesus Christ, I fucking hate this liar. They end up going all together to drink, and they're at the bar as our famous and hated mommy. 52 seconds in an elevator can't even compare the discomfort that the scene gives me. She acts like it's not weird or something, as if. Kazuya goes to the bathroom to piss and, damn, it's the 70th time. When he comes back, mommy has changed seats with someone, who was the son of a bitch who agreed to change seats with mommy. She starts spitting out more toxins than the Chernobyl accident. Even Ichinose, who has nothing to do with it, had enough. Kazuya takes mommy's side. I'm done too, it's impossible not to hate this boy. Where's Makoto from school days? I used to like him more. If you like the video, hit the like button and subscribe. I'd like to ask you to watch at least 2 videos of the channel in a row because it helps me a lot. Also make a friend watch this video too. Use violence if necessary. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Bye.